So, when near Mrs. Trewick, he suddenly made a dive at her feet, and running his head between her ankles, fairly lifted her off the ground, carrying her on his back into a china shop which was near. The old lady, keeping her balance, however, and holding on with might and main till she was safely landed on the floor, all among the crockery, much to the dismay of herself and the proprietor, and to the amusement of the small boys, giving chase, in particular. Millet adds, "This somewhat extraordinary story is vouched for by a person who was living at the time." One of the amused onlookers, presumably. It is not fanciful to suppose Maria witnessed the commotion, considering the lusty pig made its bid for freedom on market day. When Maria was in her late 20s, with her own money to spend, Mrs. Trewick was president of the Ladies' Book Club. While Maria was perfectly her own mistress, the indefatigable doyenne noted her choices in the ledger as books sent for by Mrs. Trewick between 1810 and 1812. Among the magazines and reviews are the latest bestsellers hot off the press. The Gaieties, up in Regency Fashion HQ, were described in comic verse as the wonders of a week at Bath. Less frivolous, but no less popular, was Self-Control, a novel by Mary Brunton. Among its readers was Jane Austen, whose own first novel, Sense and Sensibility, was published in 1811, and immediately bought by Mrs. Trewick for the Penzance ladies to read. Maria must have seen striking parallels with her own life. The Dashwood sisters are forced to move home when their father dies and leaves everything to their brother. Meanwhile, upheavals in her family were beginning to change the direction of Maria Branwell's life. The career of her uncle, John Fennell, caused ripples long after he left Penzance for a headmaster's job in his native Shropshire.